Can supplements boost your brain health? Forget about those over-the-counter products that promise better memory. A recent survey found that about a quarter of adults over 50 take a supplement for their brain health with the promise of better memory and sharper attention and focus. The problem? There's no solid scientific proof any of them work. Let's discuss. Welcome to episode 109 of Better Brain, Better You. Hello, I'm neuroscientist Dr. Ben Webb, sharing brain advice for a mentally healthy and happy life. How are you doing? All good, I hope. So I've got a really important episode for you today on the truth about supplementation for brain health and cognitive function. So quick announcement before we jump into this week's content. I'm starting a new series of live monthly workshops on brain care. So each month, I'll discuss a science-backed strategy to help you take care of your brain and nurture your mental and emotional health. In this month's Brain Care Workshop, we'll look at nutrition, how to use the food you eat to boost your brain health and sharpen memory. So you'll discover the importance of nutrition for a healthy brain, the foods to eat and avoid to maximize your intake of brain-healthy nutrients, to keep your brain young, balance your hormones, and improve your memory. So I'll be going live at 7 p.m. on Thursday the 22nd of September. And there'll also be a live Q&A with me at the end where you can ask me your questions about using nutrition for your brain health and memory. So I'd love for you to join me for this free live event. If you'd like to attend, you'll need to register at ologyonlinecourses.com/food memory. That's ologyonlinecourses.com/food memory. So food memory is one word. So if you can't make it, make sure you register anyway to receive the replay link. So I look forward to seeing you there. Okay, so let's jump into this week's content. So the main issue with all over-the-counter supplements is lack of regulation. There's no regulatory body in the UK, US, or anywhere in the world that evaluates the safety and effectiveness of supplements before they're sold. So products are only pulled off the market or banned after people have been negatively affected. So the regulatory bodies just look out for supplements that make health claims related to the treatment of specific diseases. So even if a product is of good quality, there are still risks that they could be toxic if too much is taken, or that they could interact with medications you are taking. So in terms of brain health, this means a supplement manufacturer can claim a product helps with mental alertness or memory loss, but not that it protects against or improves dementia or Alzheimer's disease. This way, manufacturers don't have to back up any claim that their product is effective. So many brain supplements focus on omega-3 fatty acids, such as those found in fish oil, vitamin E, various B vitamins, or various combinations. So why these? Well, there's strong evidence that certain diets, as I've talked about many times on this channel, like the Mediterranean and the DASH diet and the MIND diet, can help improve cognitive function. So these diets contain foods with large amounts of these vitamins and minerals. What's not clear is whether it's this combination of the nutrients in these diets that's beneficial, whether it's specific ones or even certain amounts or some other factors. So researchers have tried to answer these questions by testing how these individual nutrients affect cognitive health. So far, the limited studies have found no evidence they help, with a few rare exceptions. So if you've ever heard concerns about how your memory or sharpness of mind is being affected by age, it can be tempting to reach one of the many supplements that claim to improve cognitive function and keep your mind alert. Slipping a supplement into your daily routine is a relatively quick and easy way to feel like you're being proactive. But it's worth knowing that many of these supplements aren't necessary and can even be a waste of money. And what's more, there are changes to your diet and lifestyle you can make that are proven to help instead. So there are some key nutrients our brains need to function properly. So these include carbohydrates, iodine, iron, zinc, and the omega-3s. So if supplements contain these ingredients, they're allowed to carry claims that they say they contribute to normal brain and cognitive function. But you don't need to get these nutrients from supplements. You can get them from ordinary foods. And if you're doing this, taking extra in a supplement form won't have any added benefits. So some popular brain health ingredients are unproven. Other common ingredients in supplements labelled for brain and cognitive health include boron, choline, COQ10 and selenium. However, the scientific evidence, as it currently stands today, doesn't show these ingredients have any significant impact, and therefore none of these nutrients have an authorised health claim for brain or cognitive function. And many supplements also contain ginkgo biloba and herbal ingredients thought to aid brain health. But again, the scientific evidence to prove its efficacy is not strong enough to support its use. So can supplements prevent dementia? Well, as we age, it's normal that some memories or information take longer for us to recall. This is because our brains and bodies are changing. Age-related forgetfulness is not the same as dementia or Alzheimer's. However, there's currently no good research that shows supplements can help to stave off either. The Global Council on Brain Health, that's an independent group of scientists, doctors, academics, and policy experts from around the world, carried out a review of the current evidence on brain health supplements and concluded there was no evidence to prove their effectiveness. So they advised consumers not to take any dietary supplements for brain health and instead save their money and adopt healthy lifestyle and dietary habits. So the Alzheimer's Society agrees, saying, unfortunately, any supplement or treatment available to purchase that claims to prevent, slow down or reverse dementia is extremely likely to be bogus. So what can you do to keep your brain healthy? Making small but sustained changes to your diet and lifestyle can have a big impact. It can feel harder to fit these into busy lifestyles, but they don't have to be expensive or time consuming, and every little helps. So stay hydrated. One simple way is to make sure you're hydrated. Our brains are made up of around 75% water, so being slightly dehydrated can have a negative effect on brain and cognitive function. Eat healthy fats and aim for a varied healthy diet to get vital nutrients. The brain also contains fat, which is why we need fats in our diet. So these should ideally be healthy fats, such as omega-3s and omega-6s. The body can't make these, which is why you need to get them from your diet. So omega-3 fats include ALA, found in vegetable oils, nuts and seeds, EPA and DHA, found in oily fish such as salmon, sardines, mackerel and trout. Omega-6 oils are found in nuts and seeds and soybeans, vegetable oils and eggs. So other important nutrients for brain health include zinc, found in shellfish and grains, iodine, found in fish, eggs and nuts, and iron, found in beans and pulses. So lead an active lifestyle and work to prioritise sleep and minimise stress where possible. Other proven ways to optimise brain health as you age include regular exercise, eating a varied and healthy diet, switching off and having time to relax, and minimising stress and getting enough sleep where possible. Of course, these aren't all possible all of the time, but it's worth looking at small changes you can build into healthy habits and sustain over time. So as I mentioned at the top of the show, I'm going live at 7 o'clock in the evening on the 22nd of September in the first instalment of my monthly brain care workshops. I'm going to unpack how to use food to boost your brain health and memory. So you can register to attend this free workshop at ologyonlinecourses.com/food memory. That's ologyonlinecourses.com/food memory. So thanks so much for joining me for today's episode on the truth about supplements and brain health. I hope you found it helpful. Here's to your brain health and well-being, and I will look forward to seeing you next time.